distinguished ladies and gentlemen, men of the air mobility profession, on behalf of the United States Transportation, welcome to Rodeo 96 Awards Ceremony! Ladies and gentlemen, please sit back, kick up your feet, relax, and enjoy a look at this. Thank you. flies as the Honor Guard posts the colors and remains standing as Mess Sergeant Don Johnson and the AMC Band of Mid-America, directed by Major Sam Pohl, plays our national anthem. Ladies and gentlemen, please give a rousing rodeo welcome to your Rodeo 96 Commander, Brigadier General Buck Barr.
Please be seated. Distinguished guests and outstanding members of the Air Mobility Mission, I am honored to stand before you today. One of the most memorable events of my career took place 2 years ago, right here in this hangar, as we brought Rodeo 94 to a close. I was fortunate enough at the time to lead Team McChord, and immensely proud of the way this base pulled off what I consider to be the best rodeo ever. In fact, I did not think that effort could be topped. But I was wrong. Please join me in applauding our magnificent hosts for Rodeo 96, Brigadier General Select Craig Rasmussen, Colonel Bill Tomlinson, and the rest of Team McChord. Let me also hear it for the terrific staff of those people that have helped us so much out at Fort Lewis. Let's hear it for the Army, folks. What a great competition it was. Those of you in this room, just by virtue of being here, have been recognized as the very best in the air mobility profession. By matching you up head to head, we identify the best of the best, but more importantly, we foster the spirit of shared knowledge, cooperation, and teamwork, no matter what flag you fly. You bring a unique set of experiences to rodeo, and we all benefit. And so with that in mind, please join me in a round of applause for our international competitors who have come so far to join us. On behalf of all of us participating in Rodeo 96, I'd also like to extend a heartfelt thank you to the people of the great state of Washington. Okay, folks, let's hear it again for Washington. Thank you so much. And now, let's meet our winners. In the interest of a smooth running program and appropriate length, we ask that those of you receiving trophies before the intermission stay in place. Our cow folks will hustle on out to where you are with your trophies. The winner of the Security Police Combat Endurance Course event is the United Kingdom. The winner of the 10K Rucksack Run event is the United Kingdom. I don't know what's gotten into our Brits this year, but they're running well. They did a lot of other things well. I'm surprised they could run. Back to the script. I hope you all got a chance to catch your breath, because things now are really going to get exciting. And for this segment of the awards presentation, I'd like to invite the Commander-in-Chief, United States Transportation Command, to the stage to assist me in handing out the silver. General Rutherford. performances in the individual event awards we presented earlier count towards our team awards, which we will begin to present now. These awards identify the best of the best, the top teams in each air mobility career field. As we announce each winner, we ask that the members of that specific team come forward to receive your trophy and shake hands with the commander. Okay, let's get started. The Best Security Police Award is based on the combined performances from the combat tactics, the combat rifle, combat pistol, and the combat endurance course. The winner of the Best Security Police Team is the United Kingdom.
You have to shoot, shoot, don't talk.
Time is ticking away.
Move down.
Time is ticking away. Time is ticking away. Time is
ticking, 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 ticking. Straight up rock and roll.
Came out here, city slickers. You're gonna go home, cowboy.
Not normal. I'm telling you. Did you see his eyes? He's got crazy eyes. He's a lunatic. I'm telling you, we are going into the wilderness being led by a lunatic. He's behind me, isn't he?
Time to turn in.
We'll be right back.
tell me why should it be true that I get a belt out of you?
Hold it, hold it! What the hell is that? I'm in a song. A real song. Something like...
Our next award is presented to the best C-130 wing. It's named in honor of General Joe W. Kelly, commander of the Military Air Transport Service from June 1960 to July of 1964. General Kelly is credited with bringing MATS into the jet age when he personally piloted the first jet aircraft assigned to the command. General Kelly was also in command when MATS acquired the first C-130E model Hercules in 1962. Today, we honor him by presenting this award.
It is my distinct honor to introduce the commander of Air Combat Command, General Richard Hawley, who will present this award. Thank you, sir. Ladies and gentlemen, General Joe W. Kelly Trophy, sponsored by Lockheed Martin for the best C-130, C-160, G-222 wing, goes to the United Kingdom.
David F. L. Edwards Trophy is presented to the best international team. Air Commodore Edwards served as an exchange officer at Headquarters Military Airlift Command from 1980 to 1983. During his tenure, he had a positive influence on many people and programs, one being this competition, then known as Airlift Rodeo. His passing has deprived others of benefiting from his knowledge, professionalism, and friendship. Through this humble gesture, we honor his memory.
Ladies and gentlemen, here to present our next series of trophies, a Washington native and our Secretary of the Air Force, the Honorable Sheila E. Widnall. The winner of the Air Commodore David F. L. Edwards Trophy for the best international team is the United Kingdom.
Secret of life is?
No, what?
This.
Your finger?
One thing. Just one thing.
That's great, but what's the one thing?
That's what you've got to figure out.
This trophy is presented to the best airdrop wing. It honors Lieutenant General Harold L. George, the first commander of the Air Transport Command. Now, during the Second World War, Lieutenant General George was instrumental in Air Transport Command's mission of moving and supplying the massive U.S. forces by air. He led ATC from 11,000 personnel and 130 transports in 1942 to more than 300,000 people and over 3,000 transports at the war's end. Under his leadership, ATC developed a worldwide airlift system, which remains intact today.
Ladies and gentlemen, this year's Lieutenant General Harold L. George Trophy winner, presented to the best airdrop wing, is the United Kingdom. Thank you.